One of the most famous Space Marine chapters of all, the Blood Angels have a long and glorious campaign history, as well as a few dark secrets too. Welcome to this painting video, where we're going to show you how to paint your Blood Angel Space Marines up to Battle Ready standard. We're going to use tips and techniques to get them done quickly, so you can have them on the table and vanquishing the enemies of the Emperor in no time at all. Now in this video we're going to paint three different miniatures. We'll start off by painting a Primaris Intercessor. Then we'll move on to painting a Primaris Redemptor Dreadnought. Finally, we'll paint a Primaris Impulsor, three different models so you can see different techniques used across your army. The first model we're going to paint is a Primaris Intercessor, the perfect model to show you how to paint all the basic infantry of your Blood Angels army. Now, we've already undercoated the model here with Mephiston Red Spray, that glorious red armor color of the Blood Angels chapter. Once that's done, we then went over the whole model again with a coat of thinned down Mephiston Red paint out of a pot, just to make sure we hit all the areas of the model the spray may not have hit. So that's the base coat of the armour done. Let's move on to the first stage of painting then, which is to give that armour a shade. And for this we're going to be using a contrast paint, Flesh Terror's Red. Grab a small airbrush for this one. Let's take some paint from the pot and apply it to our palette here like so. We're just going to make sure we've got a nice thin amount of paint on the brush, and we've got a nice point there as well. That's perfect. Then, onto our Blood Angel. Here, what we're doing is we're applying a shade into the recesses all over the miniature. So anywhere where two armor panels meet like this, we're going to drop this contrast paint into the recesses like so and work it around the entire model. Now, as you can imagine, this will take some time, so just be patient and make sure you're getting all the areas of the model you want to be red. Don't worry if you make a mistake as well, you can always go back with a pot of Mephiston Red paint and just tidy those up. There we go, that's the red shaded. Just look at the difference that makes. You can see the large areas of red have really been broken up by that shade. Okay, up next, let's have a look at painting some more details on the miniature. Now we're going to start off by painting the metal areas with Lead Belcher. That's going to be the bolt rifle, the vents on the backpack, and the handle on the pistol in his holster. Then we'll paint the black areas with Corvus Black. That's going to be the joints in between the armour, his Aquila on his chest, the bolt rifle casing, and of course that Blood Angel symbol on his shoulder pad too. First of all, it's that Lead Belcher, and for this we're using our medium layer brush. Let's take some paint from the pot and apply it to our palette here, like so. Now, this time with this paint, we're going to add a little bit of water here from our water pot, just to help thin it down so it goes on a little bit smoothly. There we go. Then, onto our miniature. Here, we're applying it onto the metal areas of the model. So, we're looking at the bolt rifle here, all the metal bits here. In fact, at this point, you could probably paint the entire bolt rifle if you wanted to, as we're going to go over the casing later on. Then, we're also going to pick out the vents on the backpack here as well. That's these vents here, and also the little circular vents under here as well. And don't forget to paint the pistol grip here as well, just hanging off the back of his waist. With the metal done, let's pick out all the black areas of the model here using Corvus Black. Now here we've got a small layer brush and we've thinned our paint down with a touch of water to help it go on real smooth. We're picking out the Aquila on the front here. We're also going to pick out the entire bolt gun casing here as well, all the black areas here. Also, don't forget to pick out the shoulder pad symbol here as well, if your model has a molded shoulder pad like this. And of course, don't forget to pick out all the areas in between the armor panels here. So these armor joints here, get those done all over the model. We're using a small airbrush here for added control, so take your time, try not to make any mistakes, but again, don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always get back and correct it later. Okay, there we go, that's the black and the metal painted in. Right, up next, let's shade both those areas together at the same time using Basilicanum Grey contrast paint. Grab your medium shade brush for this one. Let's grab some paint from the pot, like so, and onto our palette. Now here, we're not going to thin it down at all. We're just going to make sure we haven't got too much paint on the brush. There we go, perfect. Load it up, up we go, and onto the Blood Angel. Here, onto both the areas, the metal and the black, we're painting this Basilicanum Grey contrast paint. You'll notice straight away it starts shading both areas really nicely. So just add a nice even layer all over like this and let it dry and you'll see how good it looks. There we go, that's the Basilicanum Grey dried on the model. Just look at the difference it makes on that bolt rifle at the front. Okay, up next, let's paint some more details on the miniature. Now, first of all, we'll paint the leather by first painting it Mournfang Brown and then washing it with Agrax Earthshade. Then we're going to pick out the gold on the miniature, first with Retributor Armour, followed by Reichland Fleshshade Gloss. So first of all, it's that Mournfang Brown for the leather. And for this, we're using our small layer brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette. With the base paint like this, we're going to add a touch of water again to thin it down. Make sure it goes on real smooth. There we go, load the brush up. Make sure we've got a nice point on the brush. Then onto our Space Marine. Here, we're picking out the leatherwork. So we've got the holster on the back here like this. Any pouches we have as well. And of course, the belt too. Just gonna pick all of those parts out right now. Try hard here not to hit the red areas if you can. But again, don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back and correct it. Over the top of that Mournfang Brown, we're placing a wash of Agrax Earthshade to shade it down. Here, a nice even wash like this. We're using our medium layer brush here. Just make sure we're being nice and neat and hitting all those brown areas. Up next, we're picking out the golden parts of the miniature here with Retributor Armor. So we've got the sigil on the front of the bolt rifle here. We're going to paint him with gold. We've also got the area around the gem on the chapter symbol here as well. Now, don't worry if you hit the gem here. We'll go back and paint the actual gem itself later on. And also, if you've got any sigils and Blood Angel type things on your miniature as well, paint that now. The sigil on the back here, we're going to paint the area around the gem with gold. Then over the top of this, we're placing a wash of Reikland Fleshshade Gloss all over the gold areas. So there we go, that's the gold shaded and it looks pretty good. Okay, let's finish the model off now with a couple more details. First of all, we're going to paint the eyes on our space ring using Caliban Green. Then we'll pick out the Blood Angel gems using first Fulgurite Copper as a base coat and then using Spirit Stone Red gem paint over the top of it. More on that in a second. First, let's paint those eyes in, and of course for this, we're using our absolute smallest small layer brush. Let's grab some Caliban Green from the pot here, just a tiny amount like this on the tip of the brush, then onto the palette, just making sure we're taking off that paint. We've got a nice small point on the brush. Then onto our miniature. Here, we're applying it super carefully onto the eyes on our Space Marine. Brace your hand here and just let the very tip of the brush hit the Space Marine's eyes like this and work it around. Up next, we've got Fulgurite Copper, and here we're placing it onto the areas where we want there to be gems on the model. So we've got a gem right here on the chapter symbol. We've also got this one hanging down from the waist here as well. Just going to get a nice even coat of Fulgurite Copper covering like so. Next up, we've got Spirit Stone Red gem paint, and here's how we're going to apply it. First of all, we've got quite a bit on the brush here. We're going to apply it near the bottom of the gem like so. Then we'll push the paint up towards the top of the gem like this, so there's more paint at the top of the gem. And when that dries, you'll see the difference that makes. There we go, that's our Primaris Intercessor complete. Okay, let's paint something a little larger now. We're going to move on to painting a Primaris Redemptor Dreadnought in the colours of the Blood Angels. Now straight away you'll see I've actually assembled the model here in three separate parts. The main body of the Dreadnought, and then the two arms, which I've kept separate and mounted to spare flying stands to make painting a lot easier. You'll also notice I've sprayed them with Lead Belcher spray. We've done this as the metal part of the Dreadnought is going to be the messiest parts, so we're going to paint those first and get that out of the way before we move on to painting the red armour later. So, over the top of that Lead Belcher spray, the first we're going to be doing is shading all the metal areas using a contrast paint, Basilicanum Grey. So let's do that right now. Grab your medium shade brush and take some paint from the pot like so onto your palette like this. Now here, we're getting quite a lot of paint out of the pot like so, just making sure we're loading our brush up with quite a bit. Then it's onto the Dreadnought. Here, we're applying a nice liberal coat of Basilicanum Grey all over the metal parts of the Dreadnought. So it's nice and liberal like so, a nice thick coat like this all over. Try as hard as you can as you're painting on to make sure the paint doesn't pool too much in the recesses. And also try and be as neat as you can, but don't worry if you hit other parts of the model that are going to be red or other colours later on, as we're going to go back later on and paint those in. So there we go, the Basilicanum Grey has dried on the metal areas of the miniature, giving this really cool, grimy, weathered look. But up next, let's lighten that metal up a little bit by adding a dry brush onto it using Necron Compound. We're doing this now as it's going to be a super messy part of the miniature, so once that's done, we'll then go back in with Mephiston Red as a base coat on all the armour panels of the Dreadnought. When we've done that, we'll go back in with Flesh Terror's Red Contrast Paint again and use it as a shade on the red areas. First of all, it's that Necron Compound dry brush, and for this, as it's such a large model, we're using our extra large dry brush. Let's take some paint from our Necron Compound pots here, and then move it over to our piece of tissue paper. Now what we're doing here is we're brushing off most of the paint onto this piece of tissue paper like so. Just get rid of most of it there. That's why it's called a dry brush. There we go. There's almost no paint left on that brush, which is perfect. Then onto the Dreadnought. Here, we're lightly dry brushing it all over the metal parts of the model. And you can see, like this, the areas at the very edges were picked out with the detail like this. And we're doing that all over the miniature, like so. Just moving it around, making sure we're just picking out the absolute edges of these areas like so. Just give it a nice cheeky highlight. The reason we're doing this now, as it's going to be super messy, so then we'll move on to painting the red once this is done to neaten up the model. Okay, now the messy bit's done, it's time to paint the red of the Dreadnought. Here, of course, we're using Mephiston Red, the famous colour of the Blood Angels. And we've got our medium layer brush here for added control. I'm just going to go around and pick out all the parts of the model we want to be red. Now, this is going to take some time, so be patient, but be as neat as you can and try as hard as possible not to hit those metal parts you've already painted. If you're a bit confused about which parts of the model want to be red and which parts want to be metal, have a really good look at the pictures in your codex and that'll really help you out. With the red base coated on, now we're going back in with Flesh Terror's red contrast paint and applying it as a shade into the recesses all over. We're using a small layer brush here and being nice and neat to make sure these shades are super neat like this. So do this all around the miniature, take your time. Don't worry if you do make a mistake, you can always go back with that Mephiston Red and tidy it up if you need to. But take your time on this one if you possibly can. There we go, that's the red shaded all over the Dreadnought. Don't forget to paint the arms at the same time. Okay, up next, let's have a look at painting the black on our Dreadnought. His will be on things like the Aquila, the weapons casings, and various other parts of the model as well. Start off with a base coat of Corvus Black, and then over the top of that, we're going to be painting contrast paint Basilicanum Grey. Grab your medium layer brush for this one. Let's take some Corvus Black from the pot and onto our palette. As always with a base paint like this, we're going to add a little bit of water from our water pot to help thin it down so it goes on real smooth. Then onto our Dreadnought. Here, we're applying this onto the areas we want to be black. So we'll start off with the Aquila here and we'll work our way around the miniature. As always here, have a really good look at the picture of the Dreadnoughts in the Codex to get a great idea of which parts you want to be black and be as neat as you possibly can and try not to hit those red parts we've already painted. Then, over the top of these black areas, we're going to be painting a contrast paint. This is Basilicanum Grey, being applied nice and liberally all over the black areas like this. There we go, that's the black painted on our Redemptor Dreadnought. Don't forget to paint the black on the arms at the same time. Okay, up next, let's paint the other metallics on the miniature. This is going to be the gold and the brass. Now for the gold, we're going to start off by painting it Retributor Armour, followed by a wash of Reichland Flesh Shade. And then on some brass areas, we're going to pick it out with Rune Roar Brass, followed by a wash of Agrax Earthshade. First of all, it's that gold, using Retributor Armour, and here we're using our medium layer brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. Now again, here we're going to add a touch of water to help thin it down, just to make sure it goes on real smooth. Not too much though for metallic paint, there we go, that's perfect. Then onto our Dreadnought. Here we're picking out the golden areas on the model. Now there's quite a few golden areas on a Blood Angels Dreadnought. We've got the sigil at the front here, for example. We're going to paint all the lining and the visor here on the front of the sarcophagus gold as well. Just make sure you're going around the whole model and picking out anything you want to be gold right now. And again, if you're a bit worried about what wants to be gold, have a really good look at the codex and the pictures there will help you out. Then over the top of this, we're painting a wash of Reichland Flesh Shade Gloss. A nice even wash all over those golden areas, making sure you don't hit the metal areas around it. So here we have the plasma gun arm, and next up we're going to be painting the Rune Lord Brass onto the brass areas. Here I'm going to be painting it here onto the plasma conduits underneath the gun, and this will also look great on the end of the heavy flamer if you've chosen that option for the left arm too. Then over this we're applying a wash of Agrax Earthshade. Now here we're being quite liberal with this and we're using our medium shade brush to apply quite a bit. Remember, the more you put on here, the darker it will look and the more burnished the brass will look. I want a quite dark burnished look, so I'm applying quite a bit here. There we go, that's the brass sections complete. Alright, up next let's paint a really cool blue glow onto the coils on our Dreadnought's massive plasma cannon. Now for this, we'll start with a base coat of Corax White. Then over the top of that, we'll apply contrast paint, Ethematic Blue, to give it that really cool glowy look. First of all, that base coat of Corax White, and here we're using our small layer brush. Let's take some paint from the pot here and onto our palette. Now I'm going to thin this down quite a bit to make sure it goes on real smooth. There we go, that's perfect. There we go. Then onto our plasma cannon. We're going to paint the coils in. That's these sections of the plasma cannon here, like so. Make sure you're being neat here and don't hit the black area. But if you do, don't worry, because later on when we paint the contrast paint on, it'll just look like glow. We're also going to paint some Corax White here into the muzzle brakes at the end of the plasma cannon so we can get a cool glowy look there too. Next up, we're applying Ethematic Blue contrast paint over the top using a medium shade brush. And here we're applying it quite liberally to get a really cool glow look. Try as much as you can to build up the colours around the edges, so the bottom and the top like this. That way you'll get a really cool plasma glow look. There we go, that's our cool plasma gun effect complete. Okay, up next let's have a look at painting the purity seals on our dreadnought. Now first of all, we'll start off with Rakarth Flesh to paint the cloth part of the purity seal. We'll then take some thinned down Agrax Earthshade and wash it over the top to shade it down. Then we'll paint the wax on the purity seal with Phoenician Purple. First of all, it's that Rakarth Flesh. Grab your small airbrush for this one. Again, let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Add a touch of water to thin it down as always. There we go, perfect. Then onto our dreadnought. Here, we're painting the cloth on the purity seals like so. Just picking these out here, like this. These will appear on the model wherever you've placed them, of course. These purity seals come with the Redemptor Dreadnought kit. So wherever you've put them, just paint them up now. Over the top of this, we've placed some Agrax Earthshade, which we thinned down on our palette with a touch of water, just to make sure the colour isn't quite so strong. I'm just washing it over the top of the cloth like this. Then we're painting the wax of the purity seal, the circular bit at the top, with Phoenician Purple. There we go, that's our purity seal done. Okay, time to finish the model off now with a few more details. Grab yourself a pot of Corax White paint, and here we're going to paint it onto the missile tips, the lenses, the headlights, and of course the white half of the Cog Mechanicus on the back of the dreadnought. Once that's done, we're going to paste Apothecary White contrast paint over that half of the Cog Mechanicus and also the missile tips. We'll paint Soulstone Blue, a gem paint, onto the lenses on the model, before using Iandan Yellow on the headlight, and then finally we're going to use Lead Belcher to pick out the grill on the front of the headlight. First of all, it's that Corax White. Here, grab your small airbrush again. Let's take some Corax White again onto our palette, grab a little bit of water to help make sure it goes on real smooth, and then onto our miniature. So here we're picking out all those parts I just mentioned. We're going to start off at the top here with these missile tips on this missile launcher, picking out all of those right now with Corax White. Don't forget to paint the lenses here. There's quite a few in here. Just take your time making sure you're not hitting the metal parts of the model. That's why we're using a small layer brush at this point. On the back as well, we've got the Cog Mechanicus. Now here what we're going to be doing is painting the right-hand side of the skull like this. So we're just going to go up like so, a nice straight line there, painting the right-hand side of the skull white. And also we're going to paint the left-hand side of the cog at the back as well. Try and be as neat as you can here, but don't worry if you make a mistake. You can always grab that pot of Corvus Black and tidy it up. Okay, up next we've got some Apothecary White contrast paint. Here applying it over the white areas of the Cog Mechanicus on the back of the dreadnought, like so. And we're also going to put it onto the missile tips here at the front, both on the missile launcher at the top and the missile racks down here as well. With that done, now we've got Soulstone Blue. It's a technical paint used to paint lenses and gems. Now we're painting it onto the blue lenses on our dreadnought here. So pick out all the lenses you like with this, taking your time, being nice and neat again. Then we've got Iandan Yellow. This is being painted over the top of the headlight here on the side of the dreadnought. Just cover the grill at the same time. We're about to paint that in just a second. Once that Iandan Yellow has dried, it's time to pick out the grill over the top of the headlight here with Lead Belcher. Got our small airbrush here, it's taking our time to be super neat. Now once this detail is done, that's all the details on the dreadnought complete, so we'll stick the arms on and he'll be battle ready. There we go, with that detail complete and the arms attached, our dreadnought is battle ready. Okay, let's move on to painting something a little bit bigger now, as we're going to paint a Primaris Impulsor. We're going to use tips and techniques here you can use on just about any vehicle in your Blood Angels army. Now you'll notice for this vehicle in particular, we've assembled it in a number of sub-assemblies. These are smaller bits we've assembled separately to make painting a lot easier, and when once they're painted, we'll assemble the miniature at the end. We've got the main hull here, and the top plate and the top gun that have all been sprayed with Mephiston Red. Then the hover plates and the bull bar have been sprayed with Lead Belcher. So once that's all done, it's time to start the painting process. And here we're going to paint the metal part of the miniature first, as they're going to be the messiest parts. On the main hull and the top gun, we're going to pick out parts of the model we want to be metal with Lead Belcher. Then we're going to take a contrast paint, Basilicanum Grey, and place it over the top of all the metal we've got. So that's on the main hull and the top gun and all the hover plates and the bull bar. Once that's done, we'll then dry brush all those areas with Necron compound. That's the messy bit. First of all, it's time to base coat all those metal areas on the main hull and gun with Lead Belcher. And for this, we're going to be using our medium base brush. Let's take some paint from the pot here and apply it to our palette. Now, we want quite a bit of paint here, as we've got quite a lot of areas to cover. And we're going to take a little bit of water here just to thin it down to make sure it goes on real smooth. There we go, it's perfect. Then onto our impulsor. Now, there's quite a lot of metal here on this miniature, so we're going to be taking our time to make sure we've got it all. We've got the little repulsor nodes at the bottom here, for example. Just going to place those in metal like this. We've got the vents on the side here, we're going to place in metal as well. Other parts of the model here, this top section here is going to be in metal, as well as this aerial at the back. Just make sure you're working your way around the entire model and picking out all the parts you want to be metal. Again, if you're having problems working out which parts want to be metal, have a really good look at the pictures in your codex and they'll really help you out. So there we go, we've now base coated in all of the metal onto our impulsor, including the crew compartment at the back. And now we're going to be taking some Basilicanum Grey contrast paint and just adding it over all the metal areas on the entire miniature. So it's just a nice liberal coat of this Basilicanum Grey all over the metal parts. At this stage, don't worry too much if you're anything that's not metal. We're going to go back later on and tidy up all the red parts. Once that's dry, we've got some Necron compound and we're going to be dry brushing all the metal areas. So that's all the metal on the hull, the gun turret, the hover tracks, and the bull bars as well. I'm using a small dry brush here to make as little mess as possible, but this is still going to be a messy stage, so don't worry if you hit other areas at the moment. We're going to go back and tidy those up later on. So there we go. That's the metal dry brush with the Necron compound. You can see it's looking pretty cool and shiny. But you can also see we've made a bit of a mess on the miniature. Check out those blobs of Basilicanum Grey and metal all over the place. Maybe it's time to tidy those up. So let's get on to it. Let's tidy up the red areas of the miniature here by repainting all of them with Mephiston Red, just to help tidy that miniature up. Once that's done, we're then going to go into the recesses of our tank with Flesh Terror's Red Contrast paint to provide a shade. Once we've done that, we're then going to lightly dry brush over the top of the red chassis with Riser Rust to give it a bit of a highlight. First of all, it's that Mephiston Red touch-up. Here we're using our medium base brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now here we're going to add a touch of water, just to help make sure it goes onto our tank real smooth. Then, what we're going to do here is we're going around the entire chassis and just picking out bits where we've made a bit of a mess here. So we're just going to go over this blob here, for example. We're being super careful just to hit the red bits, not any other part of the model. We're going to go around the whole tank, repaint these bits in to make sure it's nice and neat. With the touch-ups complete, now we're going into all the recesses on our impulsor with Flesh Terror's Red Contrast paint. Here, we're just working around all the deep recesses like this with a small layer brush. So we're going to do it around the entire tank, all the recesses like this. And then also, we're going to pick out all the little rivets as well. Just a little circle around each rivet here, like that. Now, this is going to take some time to do the whole tank, but it's really worth spending your time being as neat as you possibly can. Don't worry if you make a mistake and you blob a little bit too much paint on there. Just grab that pot of Mephiston Red and you can tidy it back up again. With the shade done, now we're giving a cheeky dry brush all over the red with Riser Rust dry paint. Here we're using a medium dry brush, just working it all the way around the red here, being careful not to hit any of the metal parts. Now this will be quite subtle, but you can see here on the very edges, we've already got some details being picked up here by the Riser Rust. Going around the entire model here, just making sure we're picking out all the red bits, and a really nice sharp highlight on the edges. There we go, with the dry brush done, that's the red complete. Okay, let's paint some more details. First of all, let's paint the black areas on the model, such as weapon casings and handles and such, first with Corvus Black, followed by a wash of contrast paint Basilicanum Grey over the top. Then we're going to pick out the golden areas on our Impulsor, such as the Aquila on the front and various other sigils around the model too. We'll start that with Retributor Armour, followed by a wash of Reichland Fleshshade Gloss. First of all, it's that Corvus Black. Grab your medium layer brush for this one. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Again, touch of water here just to thin it down a little bit, not too much. There we go, that's perfect. Then load the brush up and onto our Impulsor. Here, let's pick out the black area. So let's have a look here at, for example, the front of the bolt guns here on the side. Any other weapon casings, we'll do the gun on top as well. Don't forget the front casing and the gun on the turret too. We're painting that at the same time. Also, we're looking at the sort of handles on the bars at the back here as well. Looking at picking out these areas here. And any other part of the model you want to be black. Once the black's painted on, now we're adding a layer of contrast Basilicana and grey over the top of it to shade it down. Nice liberal coat like this over all the areas we've painted with the Corvus Black. Next up, we're picking out the gold on our miniature. Here we're painting Retributor Armour onto the Aquila on the front of the Impulsor here, and any other symbols and sigils around the model we want to have gold too. For example, there's a skull just here, we'll paint that gold. Also, there's a little Aquila on the front of the stub gun here, we'll paint that gold as well. Then, over the top of the gold, we're placing a wash of Reichland Fleshshade Gloss. A nice liberal coat like this over the top to shade down those recesses. So there we go, that's the gold painted. Right, let's finish the Impulsor off now with a few more details. We're going to paint Corax White now over a number of bits of the miniature, namely the headlights, the lenses, then in the crew compartment, the small screens, and the shrine in the back as well, including the skull and the little purity seals there too. Let's grab our small airbrush for this. Let's take some Corax White from the pot and onto our palette, like so. Then we're going to take a little bit of water and thin it down. Bingo. Then onto our Impulsor. Let's pick out all those parts that I talked about earlier on. So we've got the headlights here, either side, which we're going to paint over. Don't worry about painting over the grille right now. We'll come back to paint that later on. We've got small lenses all over the place, such as this one that's right here. I'm going to paint that lens in right now. As well as all the small screens that appear around the turret and at the front of the tank here as well. Like so. Like this, all the way around the turret. Then, in the crew compartment, here we've got these small screens that appear in the back. Paint those white now too. As well as the skull and the purity seals seen in the little shrine in the back too. There we go, that's the Corax White painted onto those areas. Now what we're going to do is paint some paint over the top of that white to give some cool effects. We'll start off with Soulstone Blue, a gem paint, which we're going to use on the lenses around the miniature. Then we'll use a contrast paint, iron and yellow, on the headlights, before using lead belch to paint the grille over the top of the headlights. Then we can use another contrast paint, Dark Angel Green, to pick out those screens in the crew compartment, before using Agrax Earthshade, slightly thinned down with a touch of water, on the skull and the parchment of the purity seals on the shrine. Then finally we use Phoenician Purple to pick out the wax on those purity seals. First of all, it's Soulstone Blue, and for this we're using our small airbrush. Let's grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette here. Just a little bit on the brush, that's perfect. Then what we're going to do here is paint this onto all of the screens on the Impulsor. So we're just painting these screens here, for example, like this. What we're trying to do is push that paint up towards one edge to give a sort of cool screen effect. So there we go, as you can see there, slightly darker near the top here. We're going to do that on all of the screens and lenses around the miniature. Once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. Next up, let's grab some iron and yellow contrast paint and paint it over those lights at the front of our Impulsor. Here, don't worry too much about hitting the grill, as we're going to paint that in just a second. Once that's dry, we'll grab some lead belcher and very carefully pick out the grills over the front of the headlights here. Here again, we're using our small airbrush, and take your time to be as neat as you possibly can. There we go. Next up, let's paint the screens in the crew compartment here with Dark Angel Green contrast paint. Then next, we're painting the skull and the purity seal inside the shrine in the crew compartment here with Agrax Earthshade. Now we've slightly thinned this down with a touch of water, so it's going on real smooth and we'll give a nice light finish. Then we're picking out the wax of the purity seals here with Phoenician Purple. And once that's done, we're going to assemble our Primaris Impulsor. There we go. Our model is assembled and our impulsor is almost battle ready. But of course, there's just one thing left to do on all of our miniatures, and that's to provide a textured base. Now for ours, we're going to be painting a Grelum Badland onto our bases, a texture paint to make our Blood Angels look like they're fighting in a dusty plain. Once we've applied that, we'll then place a wash of Agrax Urshade over the top. First of all, it's that Agrelum Badland, and for this we're using our trusty Citadel texture tool. Let's grab some paint from the pot here onto the thicker end of the texture tool like so. Let's really load it up like this. Then onto our base. What we're going to be doing here is spreading this around onto the base, much like you would icing on a cake. The more you apply and the thicker it is, the bigger the cracks will be. So if you want a really crackled land, make a really thick coat. Apply it all over the base and leave about an hour for it to fully dry. Once it has, we'll move on to the next stage. Once the Grelum Badland has dried, it's got this really cool crackle effect. And we're going to place a wash over the top of Agrax Earthshade, which we've slightly thinned down with a touch of water. Once that's dry, we'll paint the rim of the base with Steel Legion Drab. With the wash dry and the base rim painted, that's our base complete. And with that, our Blood Angel miniatures are battle ready. Don't forget, you can use these same techniques to paint just about any miniature in your Blood Angels army. So there we go, that's how you can paint your Blood Angel Space Marines up to battle ready standard. Couple of things to remember here. First of all, when painting miniatures like this, always try and paint the messy parts first. You'll notice on the Redemptor Dreadnought and the Impulsor, we painted the messy metal bits first, then went back and painted the rest of the miniature. Second of all, when you're painting the rest of the model, take your time and try and be as neat as you possibly can. But don't worry if you make a mistake, everybody does. You can always go back and correct it later on. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting.